Next we'll go to Cori Howe synthesis. Here you have to take R2CuLi. This is called as lithium dialkyl cuprate on treatment with alkyl halide R-X. You will be getting R-R-. This R combines with this R-. You are getting R-R-, which we call it as alkane. Then R combines with Cu to form RCu. Then the lithium combines with halogen to form lithium halide. And so we are getting organocopper and lithium halide as the byproduct. And here we are getting an alkane. So this reaction we call it as Cori-Howe synthesis. It was founded by Cori, Posner, Whiteside and Howe. So it is called as Cori-Howe synthesis. So this is a very important reaction for the preparation of alkane, because here we are getting an alkane, even the odd number of carbon atoms we will be getting. So in the Woods reaction, we have said we are getting an alkane with even number of carbon atoms alone we will be getting. But here we can prepare an alkane with odd number of carbon atoms. That means we are getting ethane, butane. Likewise, here we can even prepare propane. So that is the importance of this reaction. So this is a very important reaction. And here the reagent is lithium dialkyl cuprate. This is a very important reagent. This reagent reacts with alkyl halide to form an alkane and organocopper and lithium halide. So how to prepare this reagent, that is very important. For that we will see the mechanism. So the mechanism involved in preparing this R2CuLi, that is lithium dialkyl cuprate, this mechanism involves two steps. In the first step, you have to take an alkyl halide treated with lithium method. You will be getting, when it is solvated with dry ether, you will be getting alkyl lithium. So you take alkyl halide RX and lithium metal, solvated with dry ether, you will be getting alkyl lithium and lithium halide. So you have to take two lithium metal you have to take. So this alkyl halide on treatment with lithium metal, when it is solvated with dry ether, you will be getting alkyl lithium. So this is the first step. In the second step, this alkyl lithium you have to take, which is prepared in the first step, treated with cuprous iodide, you will be getting lithium dialkyl cuprate. That is the reagent you will be getting. So you have to take alkyl lithium, which is prepared in the first step, or Li. You have to take alkyl lithium treated with cuprous iodide, CuI. You will be getting R2CuLi. So you have to take two molecules of this one, and Li I you have to take. So here you need 2R, so you have to take 2R Li. So this is the reaction. So in the second step, you are getting R2CuLi. So this is what we call it as lithium dialkyl cuprate. So lithium dialkyl cuprate is this one. So here you have this lithium dialkyl cuprate was prepared by Henry Gilman. So it is called as Gilman reagent in honor of his contribution. So here in this reagent, you have RLi, and then this RLi, where lithium is a metal electropositive, so it has a positive sign, and R gets a negative sign. So this is a carbanion, and you have RCu also. So when they are in contact, this R will get attracted towards this copper. So what will happen? You will have RCu. Then RLi you have, and this lithium is having a positive sign, this R is having negative sign, so it will donate electrons to this copper, because copper is electropositive, so it donates metal, so it donates electrons to this one. So there is a coordinate covalent bond between this R and Cu. So this is the structure of this one, this reagent structure. So you have here RLi. R is having a negative charge because lithium is having a positive sign, that is metal. So this R gets attracted towards this copper. So it will form a complex compound, a coordinate compound it will form. So because this R will donate electron to copper to form a coordinate covalent bond. So this structure you have it in mind, so then you can easily understand this mechanism. Now this Gilman's reagent, that is this lithium dialkyl cuprate only we are going to use for preparing an alkane. So here you have to take this reaction. This is Cori-Howe synthesis. So we are preparing lithium dialkyl cuprate, which we are going to use here in Cori house synthesis. So here you have to take R2CuLi, that is lithium dialkyl cuprate, on treatment with secondary alkyl halide, that is second alkyl halide you have to take, another one alkyl halide you have to take. So first one alkyl halide we have taken here. This alkyl halide can be a primary one, secondary one, or tertiary one, but this is a second alkyl halide. So you have to take this Gilman reagent treated with a second alkyl halide. You have to treat it, you will be getting. So what you are going to get, I will explain. So what you are having is this reagent, you can write like this RCuRLi. So what I have taken, the structure, the same structure I have taken here. Now what will happen when they are treated with the second alkyl halide, there is a break. So this RCu will be separated here. RCu will be separated. Now this RLi you will have, and this R combines with this R dash to form R dash. You are getting an alkane. Now this Li combines with this halogen to form LiX, lithium halide. So this is how the reaction taking place. So you are getting an alkane here. So very important things you have to make a note here. What one is, you have see the second halide, that is the second halide what we are using in Cori house synthesis. This second halide is not the same as the first one. If it is the same case, then the cross products are formed. Second one, the starting alkyl halide can be primary, secondary, or tertiary, but the second alkyl halide must be methyl halide, primary alkyl halide, or secondary cycloalkyl halide, or benzyl halide you can use. So the first halide can be primary, secondary, tertiary. So this is for the first one. But the second alkyl halide which we are using for this one, that is alkyl halide which we are using for Cori house synthesis, that one we have to use only a primary alkyl halide because it follows through SN2 mechanism. So that is why we have to use only the primary alkyl halide or methyl halide or benzyl halide, or you can use secondary cycloalkyl halide. Example, if you want to prepare propane, what type of reagents you have to take. So I have told you that the second halide must be primary alkyl halide. So from this you have to take the primary alkyl halide. So this is propane. If you want to prepare propane by using Cori house synthesis, you have to take the reagent, that is the second alkyl halide must be the primary alkyl halide. So you have to take this one as the second alkyl halide. So you have to take CH3CH2Br, ethyl bromide as the second halide, that what you are using here, second halide. Then the reagent must be CH3 twice, that is this CH3 alone you have to take, and that is then be taken as lithium dimethyl cuprate. So this is the Gilman's reagent on treatment with this second alkyl halide. This R dash X must be ethyl bromide. So when they are treated, you will be getting this propane and then CH3Cu, then LiBr. So you are getting a propane. So you have to keep it in mind that based on the product, you can select the reagent. So from the product, you can select the reagent. So in this propane, if you want to prepare, you have to accordingly take the second alkyl halide. The remaining can be taken as the reagent. So this is Cori house synthesis by which you can prepare an alkane with odd number of carbon atoms. Now here, how to prepare this reagent, that is lithium dimethyl cuprate, I will show. So first you have to take CH3Cl because we have CH3 only. So CH3Cl, this is the starting alkyl halide. It can be primary, second, and tertiary. Here we need only CH3. So CH3Cl on treatment with lithium, you will be getting methyl lithium, CH3Li, and then LiCl. That is LiCl, here I have taken X. Now this methyl lithium, second step, methyl lithium on treatment with cuprous iodide, you will be getting. So you take CH3 twice, CuLi. So you have to take two molecules of this one. So you have to take two molecules of this one. So you will be getting CH3 twice CuLi. This is what we call it as lithium dimethyl cuprate. And this lithium dimethyl cuprate only you have to use here. This is Gilman's reagent that you have to use it here for preparing propane. So this is an example. So these are the two steps for preparing this reagent. So after preparing this reagent, that reagent can be used for preparing an alkane. So this is the second alkyl halide. So you have to keep it in mind, the starting halide must maybe a primary, second and tertiary, but the second halide, alkyl halide, must be the primary alkyl halide or methyl halide. So based on the product, we have to select that one. So here you are taking a dialkyl, lithium dialkyl cuprate on treatment with a second halide, you will be getting an alkane. So here we have to very importantly note down as the starting halide must be a primary, second and tertiary alkyl halide, but the second alkyl halide must be a methyl halide or primary alkyl halide. That you have to keep it in mind. If the halide, second halide, is not the same as the first one. So here we have used methyl halide as the first one. The second alkyl halide is ethyl bromide. So if it is not the first one, then the cross products are formed. So we are getting the cross products. That is propane we are getting. So this you have to keep it in mind. So this is a very important reaction. So Kori-Hough synthesis, for that you have to take the reagent, Gilman's reagent, treated with alkyl halide. You will be getting an alkane with organocopper and lithium halide. To prepare that reagent, we need a two steps. So that steps I have given in the form of mechanism. So this structure also you have to keep it in mind. The structure also very important. So based on the structure only, we have the reaction taking place. So this is about Kori-Hough synthesis for an alkane by the use of Grignard reagent. What is Grignard reagent? So Grignard reagent is an organometallic compound. It is written as RMGX, alkyl magnesium halide, and this compound is highly reactive. Magnesium being a metal gets a positive sign or gets the negative sign. Since you have positive negative sign on this compound, it is highly reactive. And this I have given in the organic halogen compounds. I will give the link in the description box, you go through it. So how to prepare this Grignard reagent? For that you have to take alkyl halide on treatment with magnesium. In the presence of dry ether, you will be getting all MgX. Magnesium gets the positive sign being a metal or gets the negative sign. And this Grignard reagent is used for preparing an alkane. So you take RMgX, positive, negative, or gives the negative sign. Magnesium is having a positive sign on treatment with water. So when they are treated with water, this water also having a positive and negative sign, H plus ion and OH minus ion. This R gets attracted towards H plus ion to form RH. And this is what we call it as alkane. Now this Mg plus gets attracted towards OH minus to form MgOHX. So you are getting an alkane when Grignard reagent is treated with water. So we can say that the Grignard reagent is highly reactive and it is decomposed easily by water. So you take an example, instead of R, you take CH3, and instead of X, you take Br. So methyl bromide you take on treatment with magnesium. In the presence of dry ether, you will be getting CH3MgBr. So this is Grignard reagent, methyl magnesium bromide. And this methyl magnesium, for preparing this methyl magnesium bromide, you have to take a dry ether, because this dry ether is non-acidic, aprotic. But if we use water or alcohol, the water and alcohol, they are having an acidic nature, they will protonate and they will decompose Grignard reagent to form an alkane. So in the preparation of Grignard reagent, you should not use water and alcohol, because once the Grignard reagent is formed, that will be decomposed by water and alcohol, because they are acidic and they will protonate and decompose Grignard reagent. But this dry ether, which is non-acidic, so aprotic, so it will not do. So only dry ether we have to use for preparing Grignard reagent. So this Grignard reagent, that is methyl magnesium bromide, on treatment, that is methyl having a negative charge, magnesium positive sign. So on treatment with water, water is also having a H plus ion and OH minus ion. CH3 and this H, they will combine, these two, they will combine to form methane. Then this MgBrOH, they will combine to form MgOHBr. So this MgOHBr is called as basic bromide. It is a halfway stage between magnesium bromide and magnesium hydroxide. So magnesium hydroxide and magnesium bromide, that is the halfway stage between. So that is why it is called as basic bromide. So this is how you have to prepare an alkane from Grignard reagent. So we have completed the preparation of alkanes. Next we will discuss the physical properties. Thank you for watching.